Hi students, a very pleasant and warm greetings to you all. Hope you are doing good. Last session we have started to learn about OpenOffice CalC, right? And we have seen about the basic concepts in OpenOffice CalC, and today we are going to learn the important thing in this OpenOffice CalC. For what you are using this OpenOffice CalC to do some calculations, right? To do the calculations, formula is the main thing, right? So here we are going to learn about creating formula. After entering the data inside this worksheet, in this spreadsheet, we are going to create a formula, right? For creating formula, we have to know the syntax, right? Here, we have two methods to enter the formula, okay? The formula in this CalC may start with equal to or plus or minus sign followed by a combination of values, right? Either directly in the cell or in the input line, right? This formula can be entered either directly inside that cell itself or else in the input line, okay? This formula will start with, always this formula will start with either equal to or plus sign or minus sign, right? And after that only the combination of values will be entered in the particular cell or in the input line, right? As a general practice or as a general one, we'll use all the formula should start with the equal sign only, right? If any formula starts with plus or minus, the value will be considered as positive value or negative values. So we'll always start a formula with equal to, okay? And now let's see the operators so that it will be easy to insert the formula there, right? The operators means that are the symbols which is used to do some mathematical calculations, right? It may be a statistical calculation or a logical calculation. The combination of the values and the operators and the cell reference is called as expression, okay? The CalC will support a variety of operators like arithmetic operators, relational operators, reference operators, and text operator, okay? Arithmetic operators, relational operators, reference operators, and text operators, okay? Arithmetic operators, this we all know. Operations which comes in arithmetic means, what all we know? Arithmetic operations are addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, exponent, and percent, right? Addition means the operator is plus, right? And the value here, if you see this list of arithmetic operations, they have given a formula and they have given the result also, right? The value in the B column here, if you consider this as a table here, operator, that row will say it is first row, right? Here column is, if you see operator plus minus, that symbols and all are there, right? So that one will say it as the first column. So the 99, the value in column B that is given in the place 98, right? So, and in the next one, the value in column C that is given as 25. The formula in column D, that one is given as equal to, always the formula starts with the equal to, right? So, equal to B3 plus C3, that means 98 plus 25, we are giving the value of the cell or the address of the cell, right? 98 is located in B row in the third column, right? So B3 plus C3, that is 98 plus 25. And the result is given in the last column. It is given as B3 plus C3 means 98 will be added with this 25 and the result is 123, right? Same way subtraction, multiplication, division, these all we know, right? And exponent. Exponent means what? It is nothing but power, okay? The power only we'll say it is exponent and the symbol is given here in this operator column, right? 25 exponent 2, that means here we have to give this exponent symbol in between, and B3 exponent C3, that means the value 25 and 2, that means the value will be 25 power 2. So the value is 625, right? Next one is percentage. Percentage means what? Finding the percentage, right? Here 600, this value is given. This percentage operator will show the percentage of the content, right? Here we have to give B3, that 600 into How much percentage? 35% of the 600 means B3 into 35%, and the value will be 72. Right? These are the arithmetic operations. Right? The example also here they have given. If you see that percentage operator diagram, you will get the clear idea. Right? And the next one is relational operators. Relational operators are symbols. These are used for comparing two values like greater than, less than or equal to, greater than or equal to. These are the comparative operators. Okay, this relational operators, you can say it as comparative operators also, right? These operators return a value like it may be a true or false. So the result will be either true or false. Okay, let's see the operators here. First operator is greater than. And along with the greater than, if an equal to comes, we'll say it is greater than or equal to. Right? Greater than means we all know it will find whether which value is greater, right? Same way in the formula bar, if you see equal to B3 greater than C3, that means 98 is greater than 100. That means 98 is not greater than 100, right? So the result will be false, right? And next one is greater than or equal to. That means greater than or it is, if it is equal also, it will accept it, right? So greater than or equal to. Next one is less than. And the next one is less than or equal to. Less than or equal to means 55, 55 they have given. So is equal to B3 less than or equal to 55. Equal to is there. So if it is equal also, the value will be true only, right? And the next one is equal to. Equal to 12, 12. They have given both, in the both the cells, they have given 12. So it is equal, right? Is equal to B3 equal to C3. And the value and the result is true, right? Not equal to means the greater than symbol and the less than symbol together will say it is not equal to. Okay? Not equal to 54, not equal to 45. So in the formula bar, they have given equal to B3 not equal to symbol and C3. It is not equal, right? And the result is true, right? So in this way, we can just enter the formula in the formula bar in this relational operators, and the values or the result will get it as false and true. Okay? And the next one is reference operators. Reference operators means this is used to refer the cell ranges. That means a continuous group of cells will say it as a range. Okay. There are three types of reference operators. This one is used to refer the cells in this calci. Okay. They are a range reference operator, a range concatenation and intersection operator. Okay. Range reference operator, range concatenation, intersection operator. Okay. Range reference operator means it is colon. Okay. Colon is the range reference operator. This is used to group a range of cells and expression using a range operator. Like it has this syntax. So reference left and then colon reference right. Right. Here reference left means this is the starting cell address of a group of cell, or the upper left corner address of a rectangular group. Right. Reference right means that is the last cell of a group, or it may be the lower right corner address of a rectangular group cell. Understood? Range reference operator means the symbol, the operator is colon and the syntax is reference left, colon, reference right. Reference left means it is the starting cell or the upper left corner address, and reference right is the last cell address or the lower right corner address. Okay. For example, let's see here the linear group of cells means here A1, A2, A3, A5 till A1 to A5. That means it is referred as A1 colon A5. Okay. In a rectangular group of cells means A1, A2, A3, then B1, B2, B3 till D6 means it will be given as A2 colon D6. Understood? The first column in the topmost and the last column. First column and the last column. Understood? This name box will shows the reference A2 to D6. Right? So this corresponding to the cells which is included in the drag operation with the mouse to highlight the range. Okay? This next one is reference concatenation. Reference concatenation means concatenation. Do you know this word concatenation? Concatenation is nothing. We have to join it together, means we will say it as concatenation. Okay. And the symbol or the operator of this reference concatenation is child symbol. You all would have seen the symbol in some operations or in keyboard and all. And we have not known the use of that operator, right? That is child symbol, and this child symbol only is used for concatenation operator in this CALC. Okay, an expression using a concatenation operator will have this syntax: reference left, concatenation, reference right. That means if you see, if you want to find the sum of A1 to B, A1 to A6 and C3 to F3, the formula will be sum of A1 colon A6 concatenation C3 concatenation operator. What is the concatenation operator? Tiled symbol, right? So the tiled operator we are giving, and then C3 colon F3, right? Sum is the function to find the sum of a group of variables, right? So inside this sum, they are giving this a child symbol or this concatenation operator. Okay. The next one is intersection operator. Intersection operator means this is used to join two sets of groups, right? It is a very similar to range concatenation operator only. The insertion operator is represented with the exclamation mark. Okay. Exclamation mark, we all know. The syntax of this intersection operator is given here. Reference left, exclamation mark, reference right, right? If you see this example, here they have given A2 colon D2, then exclamatory mark B2 colon E4, right? That means the range 1 is A2 colon D3 and the range 2 is B2 colon E4, right? The intersection of this range 1 and range 2 only, they have given this exclamatory mark in between this two ranges. Okay, so this will be selected. That intersection happens here in B2 colon D3. Okay, the result of this A2 colon D3 exclamation B2 colon E4 means this is referred by a range B2 colon D3. Okay, because these cells are in both the sides. That means inside A2 colon D3 and B2 colon E4. Okay. If you see this worksheet with intersection operator, you will get a clear idea. It's in page number 115. Just refer it when you are reading this chapter in your book, right? And the next operator is text operator. Okay, in this CALC, OpenOffice CALC, AND operator is there, right? This is the text operator. Okay, here this is used to combine two or more text. For joining, we saw the word as concatenation, right? So to join two different text, we'll say it as text concatenation. Okay, the expression using used for this text operator means here text reference 1 and this AND symbol is there, and then text reference 2. Okay, here if you are using this AND symbol in between two cell reference text reference, that two cells will be merged and it will be displayed here in the particular cell where we click and where we are giving this formula. Okay, when this arithmetic operators are used in a formula, this CALC calculates the result using the rule of precedence followed in mathematics. Okay, the order is first the exponential things will be calculated. Exponential means the power that will be calculated first, and then next negotiation, that is negative value, will be calculated, and then third only multiplication or division is calculated, and at last addition and subtraction will be calculated, right? If you are not giving any bracket, you are just giving the operators, arithmetic operators, means if there is exponential symbol, addition symbol, subtraction, plus minus, multiplication, division, negotiation symbols are there, first exponential will be calculated, and then negotiation, and then the multiplication and division, and then the addition and subtraction, right? They have given an example to show this precedence, rule of precedence, here in page number 116. when you are reading this chapter, just go through this and get a clear idea of this. Right here they have given the register number, name and the marks for Tamil, English, computer science, commerce, accountancy likewise. And they have given a small red triangle indicates the column width, which is not enough to display the entire text. Likewise, they are given in this 7.22 diagram. This is the worksheet illustration. Okay, here if you see, you have typed the name here, and if the name is bigger than the cell, it will be there inside the cell, but we can't see that, right? If the displayed cell range is not enough for the particular name, that means a small red color triangle symbol will be there, that will indicate the column width is not enough to display the entire text likewise, right? Then the construction of formula. To construct a formula, we have to follow some steps. Okay, the cell pointer should be in the cell in which you want to display the result. Okay, the cell pointer or the cell, active cell, this one cell will be selected, right? Or where the cursor is there, that one only must be the cell where you need the result. Okay, formula should always begin with the equal to sign. Okay, equal, that sign, equal to sign, only the formula must begin. Okay, in a formula you have to use only the cell reference, that means you have to use only the cell address. You should not use the actual values there. The cell address only you have to give inside the formula bar, right? While constructing a formula, BODMAS, Bodmer's rule, should be kept in mind. What is Bodmer's rule? That's nothing but BODMAS, that is bracket. B stands for bracket, O stands for order, D stands for division, M for multiplication, A for addition, and S for subtraction. Okay, brackets, orders, and then division, multiplication, addition, subtraction. This rule only must be followed when constructing a formula. And the general syntax of constructing a formula is, first equal to symbol you want to be there, right? First equal to, then cell reference 1, and then the operator, and then cell reference 2, and then again operator. If it is a big formula, we can give it in that same line itself. Or if it is just A plus B, means first we have to give the cell address of A, and then the operator, plus or minus, whatever operator it is, you have to give the operator, and then cell reference B, that is the address of B. And then again you can give, if you need to add something else, again you can give the operator, and then again you can give the cell reference number, right? And then cell reference means it is of two types. First one is relative cell reference, and the next one is absolute cell reference. Okay, if you refer a call address directly while constructing a formula, we'll say it as relative cell reference. Okay, relative cell reference means you are referencing a cell address directly. That means when you are writing a formula, you can just write here. If you see this example, you'll get the clear idea. Adding values of A1, B1, C1, D1. That means here you are giving is equal to A1 plus B1 plus C1 plus D1. That means this is relative cell reference. Okay, the same way for addition, subtraction, multiplication, and average also, right? In the other one is absolute cell reference, right? Absolute cell reference means while writing a formula, if you use this dollar symbol in front of a column name and the row number, it will become absolute cell reference. They are adding values of A1, B1, C1, D1. That means here before this A1, before this A, they have given a dollar symbol, and before 1, a dollar symbol is there. And before B, a dollar symbol is there. Before 1, a dollar symbol is there. If that is absolute cell reference, means we will be giving the formula as equal to dollar symbol A, dollar 1, plus dollar B, dollar 1. Likewise, the formula will be of dollar symbol in front of the column name and the row number. That is absolute cell reference. Okay, now you have got the idea about the difference between relative cell reference and the absolute cell reference, right? In this expression, all the cells no need to be relative or absolute. You can just mix both and give a type of reference also, right? The section explained here is the use of relative cell reference. That means about absolute cell reference, you will be learning in the next chapter and all. Let's see finding the total for this example. Okay, first you have to move the cell pointer to H2, that is the total column, and then you have to type the formula and enter the formula. After entering the formula, you have to press the enter key. Okay, how will you enter the formula? You have to give equal to first and then the cell reference, and then the, if here we are going to get the total only, so you can give plus C1 plus D2 plus whatever cell you need to add. You can just give the cell reference or the address of the cell, and you can get give the operator in between, and at last, after giving, after entering the formula in the particular formula bar, you can just press enter key. Now you will get the sum of all these values in the particular cell, okay, in that active cell. This formula clearly says how the worksheet are working with the cells, right? While referring to this address cell, address of the cell in a formula, here the spreadsheets will read the value inside the cell that you refer. You can just click on a cell and the cell address will be displayed there automatically, right? Here about constructing a formula in worksheet, here they have given an illustration in page number 118 and 119 also. When you are reading this chapter, just make a note of this and try this if you are having a laptop or computer in your home, right? Thank you for your valuable time. Stay home, stay safe, take care, bye.